Hey guys, my name is Shashwat and I'm a legal intern at LEXIS AND COMPANY. In this video, I'm going to talk about what is abduction and kidnapping and how are they different. So let's start. Though Indian laws prohibit the abduction and kidnapping since 2005, more than 1 lakh kidnapping and abduction cases have come up in India. People have continued to take advantage of the tender age of minors to kidnap them and exploit to force them to perform horrendous acts. Such offenses are an attack on the liberty and freedom of citizens, and they must be prevented. Section 359 and 2374 of Indian Penal Code 1860 provides for the punishments of these such offenses. In this video, I'll be discussing about what is kidnapping and abduction and their difference. So let's start with kidnapping. Kidnapping means taking away a person against his or her will by force, threat, or deceit. Usually, the purpose of kidnapping is to get ransom, or for some political or other purposes, or to, you know, have some to blackmail so that they can get some work done by the parent or any guardian of that minor. Kidnapping is classified in two categories in section 359 of Indian Penal Code and is defined in section 360 and 361 of the IPC. So, as per section 359, the kidnapping are of two types: kidnapping from India and kidnapping from lawful guardianship. These two are explained in 360 and 361. Kidnapping from India is that if any person takes a person beyond the limits of India against consent of a person or against the consent of someone who is legally entitled to give consent of that person's behalf, then the offense is kidnapping from India. And under 361, that is the kidnapping from lawful guardianship. According to this section, if a person takes a minor under the age of 16 or a person of unsound mind away from his or her lawful guardian without his consent, the person commits an offense of kidnapping the minor from the lawful guardianship. So this is the difference between from India and from guardianship. Then comes the punishment of kidnapping, that is mentioned in the section 363 of IPC. The punishment is prescribed as the imprisonment, either description, which can extend till 7 years, and a fine. Imprisonment of either term means either of two imprisonment prescribed in IPC, that is first simple imprisonment and rigorous punishment. They both go by their name, and that is it. Then comes abduction. The section 362 of Indian Penal Code defines abduction. It says that if a person compels another person to go from one place or entices some persons to go from one place, then the offense of abduction is committed. Thus, abduction is an offense in which a person is moved from one place against his or her will by forceful compulsion or by use of deceitful means. Clearly, essentials of abductions are I'll explain you about with an example. Suppose B slaps and hurts A and tells her that if she would not leave him, he would kill her. In case B commits the offense of abduction, as he uses, in this case, B commits this offense of abduction as he uses useful, forceful means to take A away from her house and take advantage. Here, A is the person abducted and B is the criminal, threatening A to kill her and slapping and hurting her amounts to use by using of some force. And also taking her away from her house establish the essentials of taking a person away from a particular place. Then, so let me tell you about what the there is what is the major difference between both the abduction and kidnapping. First, the kidnapping is mentioned in section 359 and abduction in 362 of IPC. Then in kidnapping, the age under the it is done under the age of 18. The person must be below 18 years. And in abduction, there is no provision for such any age bar. In kidnapping, the person is taken away or enticed. The means of doing these is irrelevant to constitute the crime. In abduction, force, deceit, or compulsion is used to make the person from a place. Then comes the nature and punishment. In kidnapping, since it is a substantive offense, its general punishment is prescribed in section 363 of IPC as imprisonment for a term up to 7 years and a fine. And in abduction, it is an auxiliary offense. It does not have any general punishment prescribed under the IPC. Rather, the punishment of specific types of abductions is given in different sections of IPC. That is it from my side. Thank you.